In this video, you'll see how to manage AWS support cases with Atlassian Jira Service Management. With this solution, you can send and receive support cases between the services using request forms that can be customized for more accurate correspondence and synchronize case communication with the AWS Support Center. We'll begin in the Jira console, where we'll open the AWS Service Management Connector page. The AWS Accounts tab is where you connect your accounts. For our purposes, we already have a few connected AWS accounts. Let's view the connector settings. There are several AWS services enabled by default. To configure AWS support, select AWS support. Let's look at the AWS support configuration. This is where you link Jira projects to AWS accounts. In this example, both of our AWS accounts are associated with our test Jira project. Let's save the settings, which will begin the synchronization of the enabled services. We can now generate AWS support cases from the Jira Service Management console. Let's create a new issue. Our associated project is the default. We have both the issue type and request type set to AWS support case. Let's summarize the issue and then add a brief description. Next, we'll rate the priority. We'll need to select the AWS account the issue is associated with. Finally, we'll specify the AWS service and category and create the issue. When the issue is submitted, an AWS case ID is created automatically. Let's navigate to the AWS Support Center to find it. The issue appears in our list of active cases. Let's reply to the issue. We can respond through the web, by chat, or by phone. To add the response to Jira Service Management, we must use the web contact method. Let's submit our correspondence. Now let's return to the project in Atlassian Jira Service Management to see the response. Here's the response from the AWS Support Center console. We can add an internal note that will only be seen here and not sent to AWS. Now, let's reply to the customer with the issue and include an attachment. This reply method has a bi-directional sync between AWS and Jira Service Management. We'll include a screenshot. Let's save the reply. Now let's return to the AWS Support Console and view our supported cases. We'll select the case we created. The record includes all the correspondence for this issue. Notice that the internal note we saved in Jira Service Management did not come over. Now, let's access the same project through Jira Service Management. This time, we'll go to Channels and open the Help Center. This landing page can be configured by the Jira admin. Let's select AWS Requests and create a new AWS support case. Jira admins can configure this request form to include more specific fields. To do that, let's switch to the Jira console. We'll navigate to Project Settings and select Request Types. Under Unassigned Request Types, we'll select AWS Support Case. We can click and drag the non-required fields to add or remove them from the form. For our purposes, we'll discard the changes and continue with the default form. Let's return to Jira Service Management and fill in the request form. The request to initiate a support case has been sent. Now let's go to the AWS Support Center and view the support case that was created. Notice that the case has been given a case ID. Let's resolve the case. The case now has a status of resolved. Switching to Jira Service Management, we can see that the support ticket notes this status change. In the Jira Help Center, we see the same comment stating the case has been resolved. Next, we'll resolve a ticket from the Jira Service Management. Let's filter for issues to show only AWS support cases. We'll select the one we want to resolve. Let's change the ticket status from open to resolved. Now we'll specify the resolution and resolve the issue. The ticket is now resolved. Let's return to the AWS Support Center and refresh the list of support cases. The status has automatically updated to show the issue is now resolved. You've just seen how to manage AWS support cases with Atlassian Jira Service Management. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.